All right, we are back for another episode of the Sweet Cherry Podcast. If you are new, welcome, welcome. I hope you enjoy our little show. Join in on the conversations. Give us some stories. Give us some
suggestions.
There you go.
Hey, everybody.
For those of you that are new, I am Cherry
and I am Fox,
and we are a part of the Sweet Cherry Podcast. And basically, you know, we just talk a lot of crap, give advice on things that nobody asked for. what else? You know, we just
talking a lot of
giving our opinions and life experiences, you know, because sometimes people are going through things and it's good to hear from someone that has gone through a specific thing, you know,
similar situation.
So today we got a little something. Today's topic: could you date a bisexual man compared to a bisexual woman? And straight off the bat, for me, is a no.
Yeah, I have to agree. Totally a no for me too.
Yeah, I cannot. That's a complete turn off for me. Like,
yeah,
I can't. It's just not. Now, I have nothing against people or anything, you know, that are bisexual, men, women, whatever floats your boat, I don't give a shit, you know. Just my preference, I could not have a man be my man and be bisexual.
Yes, exactly. I completely agree with that. I'm not at all against any of that either. It's just, I like my man very manly.
Masculine. Yeah. Very man. Exactly. Not that there aren't masculine gay men, right, yeah, or bisexual.
Let me rephrase that.
But
just not
that are strictly into feminine women.
Yes,
into women.
Exactly.
So yeah, I could not do it. And I know it sounds like a double standard because I could probably mess around with a bisexual woman.
Right. I mean, I think that's more, you know, I don't really like, you know, the whole, I mean, if you're, you know, a bisexual, but are like a girl, or you look and act like a girl, I think.
Oh, like you're not dyke-y.
Right. Uh-huh. Right. And that's, yeah, I think that I would prefer, like, if that was the case, I would prefer to date someone like that. You but know, if she was bisexual, she would have to still be girly.
All right, so masculine. Let's say she is girly, but she likes the masculine.
As
female.
Long as she's girly. Oh, say that again.
So the girl might be girly, but she might also like more masculine women.
Oh. Well, she ain't getting that from me.
Well, no, but I'm saying she goes, you know, she can date a femme or she can date a more,
what
they call a stud.
Right. I mean,
it doesn't bother you either way.
No. The man thing is totally like out of the question. That's out of the question for sure.
Yeah.
But with a girl, I mean, you know, she can be, if she's bisexual, she's bisexual, fine. But she's kind of have to be girly. She can't be.
I'm going to say something that people probably are not going to like.
Sure.
But this is like my opinion and what I think. You don't have to agree. And I take away nothing from other people's preferences or what they consider beautiful or sexy or right or wrong. I don't take away, you know, you have your own opinions as well as I have mine. But to me, I think it's sexier to see two women together.
Yes.
In a sense.
I would have to agree. Yes. I think so too. Maybe because we're women.
Maybe we're being, you know, biased because we are women. But yeah, I think, in my opinion, don't come for me. I just think it's sexier.
It's just, yeah. I agree with that. Yeah. I don't. you know, being with somebody who
women are, first of all, I think women are so sensual, you know, like yeah. they're sexy, they're sensual, they're
right.
feminine,
yes,
just beautiful,
right, and sexy, and yeah.
Yeah. So
the whole, more attractive than, but that's also because it's us seeing it,
right,
you know?
Right. That's true. That's true. Yeah. Because there are people that are going to say, well, two men are beautiful.
Exactly.
Which it can be. If that's what you think is beautiful,
right? Exactly.
You know? I'm not saying that it's not beautiful. It's just not my,
not your style, right? Same thing with me.
Yeah,
exactly. Like, I wouldn't want to be with a guy who's, I don't like feminine qualities in a guy. You know, that's not. I mean, no. And if, what if he's bisexual and he is kind of feminine at the same time? Like, that would turn me off.
Yeah, but what if he's bisexual but he's not feminine? Like, he's acts masculine and he's like manly man, and
yeah, old, but you still, you know, want to go do somebody's booty hole. I mean, a man's booty hole.
At the end of the day,
true,
true. Yeah, no, I don't see it. It's a total. Now, what if the guy is masculine or whatever, and he wants, and he's into transgender women, a man that's, you know, transitioned right. into a woman, mm-hmm. and they look beautiful.
Yes.
They look like a woman. Mm-hmm. I mean,
lot of them do. Yeah.
Would you consider that?
No.
Yeah, me either. Because once they pull out the schlong, it's a wrap.
Yeah, that's it. It's just.
Yeah, I just can't.
No.
No. Yeah, I couldn't do that.
I don't think I can, no. Definitely, you know, if it would be a bisexual woman, definitely over a bisexual man. But like I said, with her, I just don't like that butchy, like, you know, like you could like girls, but you got to be the feminine type
for you to be okay with it.
Right.
Or, you know,
exactly.
Right.
Yeah. That's how I feel about it. How about you?
I feel the same
with the women, right?
Yeah. Yeah. I do feel the same. I don't think, I don't know, because I just like, I'm not, if I say it, it's going to come out wrong. I was gonna say, because I just like pretty girls, but you can be a pretty stud.
Yeah. Yeah,
you
that's
can
true.
Be a good looking, you know, stud.
Right.
You're just not feminine, but you're still good looking. You're still right. beautiful.
Yeah.
Or whatever.
Yeah, yeah,
you know?
Yeah. Because mm-hmm. there's a lot of them that are beautiful, you know, that do act, you know,
more
masculine. Masculine. Yeah, right. Yeah. A lot of them are. You're just like, wow, if only you wore a dress.
You know what's what I find so weird is that I think for me, like once I'm introduced to someone in a way, mm-hmm. I can't see them different. Like,
any other way.
Right. So like if you came up to me, you're addressing me as a more like a stud or a more masculine lesbian. That's how I see you. So if you came one day and you came with a dress on, I would be like, that's totally weird. Like, it looks off. Like, you shouldn't be wearing that.
What if they looked really fly as like the mannish look, right?
Right.
And then they have the whole walk and everything. And then they just come one day as a total girl, like everything, even their walk, like, the way they act. That would be so dope, right? If you could really master both of them.
Yeah.
And like the walk and everything, because, you know, there's a whole walk, there's everything, the way you stand.
Yeah, yeah.
That would be pretty cool. But that would definitely throw you the hell off.
Yeah, like I would be like, are you the same person? What is happening now? Yeah, it's hard for me to always, like, you know, flip the back and forth of you know, what you are and what you, you know,
if you're so used to, right,
yeah, like you could see the person for a year and they're looking the same all the time, and then one day they're like, oh, I'm going to a wedding, and they got a fucking ball gown on.
That's cool though. I would like to see that.
Yeah, I have not seen that.
Me neither.
That I have not seen. But again, that would tie back because I was like, what about a guy? Like, he's masculine. Then one day he just comes out. He's out like and wearing a skirt.
Yeah.
No.
Stockings and a thong.
Like, I'd be thinking like Kris Jenner.
Yeah, you know what I thought of him? And that was the first person I thought of. But he, you know, yeah.
Bruce Jenner, that was Caitlyn Jenner.
Caitlyn. Is it Caitlyn?
It's Caitlyn now.
Caitlyn now. Okay. Mm-hmm. I think he looks better as a woman. I kind of do. I thought he looked a little strange as a man.
As a man?
Yeah. But that might.
I could see it. Oh, but he had a lot of.
Maybe it's the work that he got done.
Yeah, I was gonna say
that's probably what made him look a little
work done. So I don't think it.
Because it's to me.
But I heard when he was like young, like when he was the Olympic champion back in.
He was. What was he in gymnastics? Was it gymnastics? I forgot what he was.
Oh, I think he was a runner.
Oh, okay, okay. Track or whatever.
Track, yeah, yeah, yeah. And that he was really handsome guy.
Really?
Yeah. I mean, then again, that's probably 80s, 70s, yeah, or no, something like that. So right. The style of men were like a little bit different.
Different.
But
with the hairy chest and the.
I don't know if he had hair on his chest, but he had long hair.
Big back then.
His son is nice looking.
Oh, I don't even know what his son looks like.
His son, Brody. Brody. He has a couple of. He has a couple of kids aside from Kris Jenner.
Okay.
He has. Other kids from his first marriage.
Wait, but Kris Jenner was just the two girls, right?
Yeah.
Okay. Okay.
Yeah, but he has two or three sons, I think.
Right. So he always wanted to be a woman. That's what it was, right?
I think that was the story that he always felt like he was a woman,
or should have been a woman.
Yeah.
That's so crazy.
And then it just took.
I just think it's just crazy because, like, how did you spend your whole life like this, you know, and didn't. Do it sooner or something.
Because I guess, you know, they feel ashamed or, yeah, guess, you know. Yeah. And then you have kids, so maybe you don't want to, you're embarrassed to bring that, like, around your kids, yeah, or something like that.
Right,
you know?
And hurt them or embarrass them. Right. Yeah, I guess that's right. Yeah, that makes sense.
Now society is more acceptable in a way.
Yeah.
Compared to back then, for you sure. Because, of course, there are still people that are not acceptable. You know, yeah. They don't want to hear about any of that crap, you know? But yeah. But I heard like they knew, like she knew that he liked to dress as
I was going to say, she probably their bedroom activity was probably very freaky. I'm sure he probably, maybe. You know, was like probably you doing
think,
stuff like
you think,
that.
You think that maybe she.
Yeah.
Yeah, I do. You think she strapped one on?
I sure do. I think so. Yeah, because, you know, especially he probably dressed up as a woman, you know, and stuff like that. I'm sure he must have done stuff like that, especially if that's what he wanted to do.
Time, so.
You know, hey, that's what she, you know, she had to have known at that point.
Yeah, I mean, I heard that she knew, but, you know, she just, like, let it slide, well, or it wasn't.
I'm like, over here talking like that actually happened. I'm like, she had to have known at that point. We don't know if that's really what their sexual activities were like, but I mean, I would think that maybe he probably like
did something.
Yeah, like that. Probably dressed up as a woman or
oh yeah
stuff
yeah,
like that.
Yeah, I heard like she caught him one time like in something of hers or something like
oh,
that.
Oh really?
Yeah, yeah, yeah. I did hear it. But I mean, who knows if it's true? That could be a rumor. But
right,
I think like first of all, I believe 100%. There's always some sort of sign somewhere, especially if you've been with somebody for so long
and you know them.
Like yeah, like you have to know something. Like there's no way you're not gonna know a little. Get like a little clue of
a hint or something because nobody's perfect. Everyone you could try to, you know, mask it and hide it, whatever, but you're gonna let something slip. You're gonna let something slip. Something.
Yeah, yeah.
something along the way is eventually going to slip, and that person's going to catch it, and you're probably not even going to catch it. They're going to catch it.
Yeah. I don't know. I always thought he was kind of...
I mean, whenever I saw him on the show,
like, I didn't find him, like, very, like, lovable or affectionate.
To her. Yeah. I felt
like
that way too.
They were like a little, you know, like she kind of was always did her own thing or whatever. Mm-hmm. Or like to bring him into conversation or into whatever, she would be like, right? Or, you know, what do you think? You know, like bring him in like that. But like, I don't feel like.
Quiet.
Quiet.
Probably thinking about justice. I'm joking.
Like, damn. I wish I was wearing that Prada. Yeah. That Prada
Kim is wearing a really nice pair of heels today. I really think I kind of probably look better on me.
But yeah, I mean, and I'm not going to say anything about, you know, cross-dressing, because pretty much in the early 90s, that's what we did. With the baggy clothes.
Oh my God.
And dressing really like boys.
Because remember, there was some boy looks that we had for sure. Like, I remember those like shirts that didn't we have ties?
Oh, yeah. There was a with tie. Vest. Yes. And the ties. Yeah. And the baggy clothes, like jeans and stuff like that.
There were
like
some
that.
Styles that were very questionable.
And that were more, you know, we could have said they were more geared to boys.
Guys, yeah.
For and, sure. You know. The girls did it all the time, you know, and that was okay. Like no one made a big stink about it, you know?
Yeah.
But it's just like when it came to men, it was like, no, you can't do that. Yeah. Yeah. But whatever floats your boat.
Definitely not knocking anyone or anything like that. Yeah. You know, what you may like, your preference, because everyone likes what they like and there's nothing wrong with that. But,
right.
We just, I think we're in agreement on how we feel about that situation. Me personally, I couldn't be with someone who's a male who's bisexual.
Yeah, me either.
No, it's just, and just to know that it's been,
it's been touched.
It's been in places where.
Things have been in places,
right?
Have been for me,
right? Exactly. So yeah, that's me. That's my opinion on that.
I don't think I. Not that I don't think I know that it's not. It's not a for me. It's not attractive.
Not attractive
to me.
Okay. But what is it about? What is it with you? That you don't like about it, that you wouldn't like about it.
Pretty much the same like you. Like I like a manly man, right. A masculine man, you know. And there have been times where I've noticed like things in a guy, and it kind of just like puts a damper in it because I'm like, that looks funny, or that sounds funny, or they sound funny,
or
something funny going on over here.
Not feeling it though.
and nothing had ever, you know, ever occurred or happened that I had ever known of, or they never came out as being bisexual, or they never, you know, at all. But just that thing kind of just like turned me off about them. Did I still date them? Probably.
Yeah.
I mean, you know, because once in a while, you know, if a little funny sound comes out, I can, you know, kind of overpass it. But if you're doing it like all the time and it's like part of who you are and
like with this funny sound, you mean like sexually or just like talking regular and like, you know?
What was the question again? It just, my I totally went completely blank.
The guy that you dated, that you, you know, that, but you said that you possibly still kept dating.
Right.
What the funny, like, was it a funny sound? Like, you meant, like, is it, like, was it something that was funny in bed? Like, a funny sound you heard? Or just in general talking?
No, not in bed.
Oh, okay. It was just, like, through, like just regular talking, conversation like, and stuff.
Comment that they might have slipped by oh, and or they something. Just... And I was like, what? That can't be right.
Right.
That's not right. And then, like, you know, it was like that one time. And then, you know, if I'm just saying, I don't remember if they did it again. But if they did it, like, maybe months later or a year later or whatever, like, I would still be like, oh, you know, but the majority of the time they were just, they're regular, right, you know, right, being regular. So it's like, maybe they're just saying something stupid and whatever.
Yeah.
And I look past it and, you know, or, you know, but if they kept doing it, like, just constantly, like,
you know, okay,
yeah, then like, it's
something's
like,
happening.
Yeah. Sir, excuse me. I have a question for you.
Do you like to get...
Do you like me and them? Like, is that... Because it's not going to happen. It's not going to happen here. No. It's not happening. I can't do it. Because I just... Sexually, for me, I lose, like, the passion or that's... spark between me and the person, I would lose it.
Yeah.
I would lose
it. It would just be a turn off for you.
Complete turn off.
Okay.
Like, whoop, shut down.
Like if you had a wee-wee, it would go all the way down.
It would shrink into my stomach.
It would be a part of your stomach.
It would become my belly button. Yeah. I would not. I couldn't. I don't do it.
Yeah.
And I would say, like, that sounds not right.
Right. That didn't sound too good. You okay?
You're right. Like, that doesn't sound right. You're right there.
I have a lot of questions.
I have some questions now. You put doubt in my head. You made me question what's happening.
You made me think.
Yeah. Should I leave or should I stay? Yeah. But yeah, I couldn't do it. I do think I would tolerate a bisexual woman.
Yeah.
And I don't care if y'all say I'm a hypocrite.
I mean, it's just what I'm not knocking anyone.
Right, I'm not knocking anyone. This is my preference.
It's
you
just
know?
What you, everyone has their own preference.
Yeah, but that would be me.
Yeah, because no, that's just too much.
Because now I have to worry about you, like when you go out by yourself or with the boys.
Yeah, what are you boys really doing? You know, or like where are y'all going and. You're not just thinking about females now being a threat. Now you're thinking about a male being a threat. Like,
right, because if you're attracted to both.
Yeah. You might be today. You might wake up in the mood for, you know, some kitty. And then tomorrow you might wake up in the mood for an eggplant, you know, like whatever.
Yeah. Yeah. And not only that, like, what if they end up, you know, leaving you for. I know.
Somebody in the opposite sex.
Yeah.
I think that would be so like, oh my God.
I mean, I would like be, that would hurt, like put a little dent in my self-esteem, right?
A little dent. I mean, usually situations like that is just something they've always felt and it was just been hidden for all their whole life.
Right.
So, you know, that's really, really how you have to look at it.
Right.
But we're not going to look at it that way. Not in the beginning, at least. It'll probably take time to get to that level.
Right.
But, yeah, that would be, like, some devastation right there. Like, oh, my God, my man left me for a man. Like, what?
Yeah. And I'm not going to be nice about it either. Especially like if you really like them.
Oh my
like,
God.
You know, like you have feelings.
Yeah,
and
yeah.
And yeah, I'm not going to be nice about it.
What are you going to do?
I'm going to just.
F everything up. Mess everything up.
Yeah, and I'm going to just probably say not a lot of nice things.
Yeah. Yeah. Probably do not a lot of nice things. Maybe some I will tires try not might be slashed.
I'm going to try not to because I feel like, you know, that was the old me.
I've grown
and I matured. So I don't think I would go like that crazy, but I would definitely say like a few things.
Yeah. Hell yeah, that would, yeah, you got to do some sort of damage. You can't just like, why would you, that's so much anger that you're going to feel too, because why the hell didn't you tell me? Like, why would you make me a part of your life when this isn't even, I was just like a cover up for you, you know?
Yeah.
I would be so angry too.
Yeah, like.
And definitely embarrassed, devastated, all types of shit.
Yeah, because, and I would be embarrassed too, because now, you know, now I have to go and tell everybody like, oh, we're not together because he left me for a guy.
I know. Oh my God. They're going to be like, oh my God, are you okay? No, no, I'm not.
I just feel like, just be honest, you know, if you're going to start dating, if you're going to start dating someone, you know, because if the person starts catching feelings,
then you're hurting somebody, and karma is going to come back to you anytime you hurt somebody. So,
yeah,
you know, you don't need that.
Nah. Be open. I'd rather have someone be open and honest with me, you know.
No matter how much it may hurt, right?
Yeah, yeah. Especially like in the beginning, because then I can know, you know, what I'm getting myself into, you know, and what I can open myself up to,
right?
And you know where the relationship might go, you know,
right?
Because you know, it might not be anything. It might just be a fling,
yeah,
that you might have, and that's all it's ever gonna be. Because you know, but if you came out open with me from the beginning, I would just be like, "This is not gonna work. So it's just not even."
I actually know someone that this happened to.
Oh, really?
Kind of. Not. She was dating someone, not for a very long time. Mm-hmm. I actually, you know, I thought they made a great couple also. Mm-hmm. I never, you know, suspected anything. It was very, like, a brief thing. They didn't date for a very long time, but they did make a nice couple. Like I said, I met him a couple of times. She kind of was turned off by him after a little while. Didn't really, like, last long with him. I think she was the one who cut it off with him. Mm-hmm. But come to find out, a little while later on in life, that he happened to be bisexual.
Okay.
And she found, and you know, she found out by someone who she had friends who were also, you know, gay, mm-hmm, as well. Mm-hmm. So one of the ones, the guy that introduced her, mm-hmm, to him, mm-hmm, supposedly had a whole like thing with him.
Oh.
And that was one of her close friends.
After they broke up, or
well,
during,
he said, before? I think he made it. Did he make it seem like it was? I think it was before. He made it seem like it was beforehand.
Before him,
but you still hooked them up. She was so.
Yeah, I would be upset.
She was, and yeah. I believe she cut him off and everything. Off
I
that.
Would too, because first of all. Why? Why would you do that?
Why would you set her up with somebody that
you messed around with?
Yes. What was the point of that? Why did you do that? That's weird to me. I thought that was weird. I was like, you have every right to be upset because she was so disgusted after that.
Yeah. You know, especially if the person doesn't know.
Right. So,
that, you know, that the person was bisexual, right, or whatever.
Right.
You know,
exactly.
That's like a total, you know, if she knew, then that would be different.
She wouldn't have messed with him.
Right.
Because she kind of feels like how we feel about
right,
it.
Right, right.
So I just, yeah, I thought that was crazy. I don't think she speaks to that friend anymore, but that was definitely like, she was so like she was so hurt by that, you know, and like disgusted because, you know,
because I mean, there are times where you might date someone and, you know, like they weren't for you, you know, like whatever, you guys hung out, it was cool, whatever, but you know, you weren't, it wasn't for you. But maybe your friend, like you're like, you know what? They would actually be like perfect together. Like
that's probably the way they thought about it.
Personality and, you know, the way you mesh wise. Right. And being that it wasn't like a big relationship between you and the person, you might say like, look, I did mess around with this person, but it was nothing like that.
Maybe that's how he felt about it, you know, when he hooked them up.
Oh, okay.
But he didn't say that. Right, but
the fact that he didn't say it and that she didn't even know that he was, you know, bisexual or anything, that's like a double whammy.
I know.
You know?
But that's a big one.
Yeah. But, you know, that I can understand. Yeah. But you say it, you know, like, look, I messed around with this guy, but we're still friends. Nothing has happened since. Mm-hmm. And I really think that y'all guys would be perfect together. Right. Like, you know?
Right. Because that's probably really the way he was thinking.
Right.
That's probably the way he was thinking.
But you have to address it. You can't just like, surprise.
Right. Because how Because what if, let's just say they did work out. What if she fell in love with him and good thing she didn't and she actually ended up cutting him off. But excuse me, what if she did fall in love with him?
Right. And then later
now
on,
you know this about, now you find this out much later on in life. Like not only is the man you're in love with bisexual, but you have one of your best friends happen to have had him also.
Yeah.
That's bizarre. Like that was a bad call from the friend.
Yeah,
definitely.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Be fighting. No.
I
would cut him off.
Yeah,
also.
I believe she did. But yeah, that was. Yeah.
Yeah. So
that's tough.
It is tough, you know, but you know, there are people that will.
But it does happen.
Yeah.
It does happen. And there are people that right now
that'll deal with it. Yeah. It's someone.
Exactly. Someone somewhere. True. That's tough though. Imagine you build a life with a person and you're now already like, you know, you have a family and
they just come out like,
yeah. I know. How do you even, what do you do at that point? That's just, can't do that to someone. You just can't.
Yeah.
No. So speak up, guys, you know, if you.
Yeah. Speak up.
Definitely let
beginning.
Your spouse know or someone that could.
But it's also easier said than done because people are embarrassed or shy or.
But it's wrong to have to. If you're going to be serious with someone, it's definitely wrong to keep that from them.
Right.
Give them the option, you know.
Right. Don't take their choice away.
Away. Exactly.
Alrighty, guys, so that is it for this episode. Let us know what you think. You know, could you deal with it? Could you not deal with it? Have you dealt with it? Have you anything with it?
Let us know. Comments.
Yes, let us know in the comments. Guys, if you want to catch us on other platforms, you can catch us on any streaming devices like Spotify or iTunes and streaming platforms like that. We are all over there. So if you can't catch us on YouTube, you can still listen to us on Spotify and iTunes and a few other, you know, just search Sweet Cherry Podcast and you'll find us. Alrighty, guys, thanks for joining in, and we will catch you guys on the next one. Later.